Yeah, in this video, I'll show you how I made this two-piece that I'm wearing. If there's something that you're interested, please stay tuned to this video. Yeah, let's start. So we're gonna start by drafting the bodice for the wrap dress. Yeah, so this is my measurement. My shoulder is 16. So I divided it by 2, so I got 8. My bust, my round bust is 38, and I divided by 4, I got 9.5 inches. I'm using inches. My waist is 32, I divided by 4, I got 4. So you will measure where you want your reps to stop, your shoulder to waist measurement. Then you're gonna measure the length of the dress from the waist to where you want your dress to stop. Yeah, so yeah, please use a pencil when you're drafting your pattern. I'm using a marker because I want it to be visible to you. So I squared across, then I marked the length of the back. We are drafting the back, so the neck depth for the back is 1 inch. The neck is 3 inches, but you can change the length of the neck if you like. So I measured my shoulder, then I drop it by 1 inch, then I draw the shoulder line. Yeah, we are drafting the back. So now you can measure your around the armhole, but so you measure around your arm and divide by 2. So my 8 inch, then I draw my chest line. Yeah, so I divided that line by 2. Yeah, so I find the center. It so I end the chest line, I mark my bust measurement, divide by 4, and on the waist I mark 8. My waist divide by 4, I mark it. Then I joined my waist to my chest line. So this is your back pattern. Yeah, this is your back pattern. Then I added 1 inch for sewing allowance, and I added 1/2 inch at the bottom. Yeah, so this is the back. If you want to, in case you want to put that on your pattern, you will measure your nipple to nipple, your bust band. So mine is 8, so I divide by 2, so I got 4. So my dart is 1 inch, so I will measure 1/2 on both sides. Then I will draw it, I will end it on my chest line. Then I would add 1 inch at the waist for the dart that I added. Yeah, in case you want to, but I'll make a video on the wrap with the. So I trace it the same thing for for the front, and I dropped the neck depth by 3 inches. So it is 3 inches by 3 inches, the neck for the front. So I went in by half an inch on the armhole of the front. Yeah, so yeah, if you want to edit that on the front, you need to mark your shoulder to bust, because your front dart ends 1 inch below the your bust. Yeah, yeah, like I said, so in the video on how to draft and sew the pinafore with the dart. Yeah, so this is the front. Yeah, so this is the front. I cut a full piece for the front, so you can end your wrap on the, you can just mark your bust pen and end your wrap there. Or me, I usually add 5 or 6 inches for my wrap extension. But yeah, you can cut any style that you want for your wrap top for the front. So I come up by 2 inch there on the wrap, so I will end it on my bust pen. Yeah, so this is my front pattern. I will cut 2 off the pattern. Yeah. Yeah, so now we're going to make the pattern for the skirt parts. Yeah, so yenza a pattern for is skirt manje. So udinga a waist measurement. You need your waist measurement and the length of the skirt. So here I'm making the pattern. So I folded it. I folded my pattern paper. So I took my waist and divided by 3.14, so I got 10. So I'm gonna mark 10. I'm cutting both the front and the back. So yeah, mark 10. Yeah, so I marked the 10 inch. Yeah, then I added half an inch for sewing allowance. Then I mark the length of the skirt. This is it. Yeah, I pattern lami leli the skirt. Yeah, mo measure lo alaini. Must get your half of your waist. So I'm gonna divide it into two, one for the back. Yeah, so this is the back pattern. You cut it on fold. Let's say on fold. This is the back pattern. Yeah, I'm gonna wait it fishan. So at the mass begin drawing about. Yeah. So yeah, I was making the front, so I added the extension of 4 for the wrap over extension. So this one is for the front. I'm gonna cut 2 pieces. Yeah, don't mind the short pattern. I'm gonna add it when I'm cutting on fabric. Yeah, because this is the pattern. This is the front. Yeah. So yeah, this is all my patterns. So yeah, this is my pattern. So I want my neck client to have a collar, so I drew a the video on how to draft the collar, and so it is already up on my channel. So yeah, this is the facing. Yeah, see, I already sewn the top of the dress. But if you don't want to put a collar, this is how you will cut. You will put your back on fold on your front. Yeah, you cut too. So this is my pattern. I placed it. This one I added in some inches. I have a fish and egg red dress. This is how you the fabric is on 14 inch for a back piece. So I cut 2 pieces. This one is cut on 4. I added some joining inches at the side. I was drawing the pattern for the pocket. So feeling base and the summer thing at whereby you put anything. So I was just eating because the dress is too short, but it ended up being short anyway. But I added some few inches. Then I draw do the same thing for the front. So I went on to cut the pieces for the dress. So this is it. This is my pattern for the skirt. You see, ibo piece basket laba. So la where sifaga in ama payete. So I usually come down by 1.5 inch or 2, then I place my pocket. Ngihlanga 1 or 1.5 inch or 2 inches, then ngibeka ama pocket yami mase ngiyawathunga. But I usually first overlock them. Then I take them to the sewing machine. I sew them. Then after that, I press them. I'm not saying a top stitcher, but this is optional. You can leave it more than the 16 so to top stitch packet. But this is how I like my packet to be. So now I'm gonna join the side of the skirts. So tunga lapha ngoba ngidweba ngizolandela line. So I would sew following the line that I just drew. But you must always pin your when you're sewing. So I went on to sew them. Ntungile la mwana overlock usebenzisa zigzags. You can use a zigzag on your sewing machine if you don't have a overlock. So this is it. Iphayethe lami ikhona vele video kwenza iphayethe, how to sew a payette. Then I went on to join the bottom part of the dress. Then I'm gonna use a bias tips just to design my dress. So See, I went on to sew the bias tape on top. So ngithungile bias tape on top just to lenza libe lihle iphini falami. There is no right way to make the wrap dress. You can style it as any way you like your wrap dress to be. Ngisikile la fabric of about 3.5 inches. Cuts 3.5 inches. I folded it into two, so I'm going to finish the front of my wrap dress. So how I sew it, on the right side, you see. Then I'm going to finish it with a bias tape, just like I just did now. So ngizoyiqedela nge-bias tape la in the front yengubo yami. So la sengi, I have sewn it. See, it's so beautiful. Yabo, ngubo yami le, i-bottom njalo yesikete. This dress is so short. I'm not happy about it. I'm not going to wear it. So now about go piece it. This is a piece for the front of the top and the back. This one allowance the back, so I can sew it. So I added half an inch. Interfacing for a collar, a back liner. I'm gonna pin them on the shoulder, then I'm gonna sew. The video on how to sew collar, to draft the collar, is already up on my channel. I sew the shoulders and ngithungile my shoulders of the dress. Then I went on to sew the side seams, ngithungile my side seams ye top la for wrap dress ye too. Please pin your fabric. Cela uphine bandla mothu yathunga into zakho. So this is the top, you see. Now I'm going to, this is the facing. I'm just going to sew it at the front. I'm gonna do the same thing for the both pieces. So I'm going to, you can put your wrap there, your wrap ropes, if you ungafala in ama ini lezi ntambo uzobopha ngayo wrap yakho before you sew this front. You can put them there, about 1 inch, then put your strips and pin them, then sew the front, the facings to the front. When you're done sewing, gonna take it to this iron and press open your seams. Uthatha la uyo iron masuqedile ukuthunga. So this is it. You will notch. Usike la khona izohlala kahle ukhola wakho. Kancane nje usike kancane. Mase you will take your your collar and sew it. Yeah, you will sew your collar there. You pin and sew, and then you're gonna iron it when you're done sewing it. So, tunga ukola la pana, John Bubon and tunga nam. I should get deal with your humble room. You iron. So, yeah, this is it. I need my man, I'm so you pin it to the bed neckline, so pin a lapa, kumkaleni was a peck. Kalena was a peck, masu ya tunga, go be careful, la masu tunga la. Ushanga needs to call her to the peck, you must be careful when you are sewing the collar to the back neckline. Yeah, take your time. Yes, you must take your time. Make sure you see that is your collar, it's joined to the back. So I ironed. So now I'm going to finish the rest of the collar. You can overlock your dress. Me, I'm just doing this for the purpose of the tutorial. So you can overlock your work or use a zigzag. So here I joined the facings to the shoulders. Then I pinned and so ang pinang, yeah, but you can use your pins. So la na kula ngithathi facing ngayibeka ngayihlanganisa ne shoulder khona ngizoqedela e facing, yabo ngiyathatha la e facing ngihlanganisa i-shoulder line. On the shoulder line, then I sew it. Yeah, so I sew the shoulders, the facings to the shoulder line. Yeah, so collar wethu facing it. Mase uzogoqa lapha mase uyawuthunga. You will fold it and sew. You see, just like I'm showing, you will sew it on top, making sure you're catching the collar inside. So you see, I'm done with my top. So now I'm joining the top to the skirt. So I mark the center. So mark the center, then I pin it afterwards. Yeah, pin it la the center. The top to the skirt. Yeah, so I'm going to. See, I'm folding my, taking my facing to finish it. So you see, just follow what I'm doing in the video. So you see, I'm pinning it. Then I'm going to finish. So you see, I'm sewing there. I say ngathunga ngihlanganisa ke i-waist and skirt. Ngihlanganisile sihlangene i-wrap dress yethu epinifalele, so selihlangene ke manje. So you see. Le manje nge-wrap dress yethu. We are done with the wrap dress. So now we're gonna work on the sleeve. So la, I measured the my armhole, so I cut this fabric is times 2 of my armhole measurement. So cut, you if you like you can cut circles, small circles, and pleat them to your sleeve, or you can just cut a long straight fabric. Yeah, this is a net, a two net layer. Yeah, going to sew. I make pleats and pin. I pin a lana and some pleats. So more tin doing yaku in the cool. So in the mamba with lakur of the pleats are money. So I make pleats. My plates lana, so now my plates on my inside. Manji, I'm going to sew just to hold the plates together. Yeah, so yeah, I'm not going to get my plates. Yeah, so you can cut the even fish and no me be in the so it is an a pinipin fire can also fun and mean if you be in shiny. So this is it. See, yeah. So, being fun taller, the center of my sleeves, then I mark it. I do the same thing for the second piece. So I'm not gonna pleat it, but if you like you can cut a bigger fabric and pleat it. So yeah, so and you must finish it. You can fold it 2 times and hem it or use bias tape. Yeah, so me I didn't I hem it because I'm just doing a tutorial for YouTube. I'm not going to wear it. Yeah. So So I pinned and I want to hold the pieces together. Then I'm going to join the seams of the sleeve. Then I'm going to pin it to the armhole. Yeah, so I will do the same thing for the other sleeve. So yeah, this is the sleeve. I think you ungasenza sakho sibe sihle kakhulu. Isami sibe nginikhombisa nje ukuthi senziwa kanjani. So yeah, nindwa ngibisi phelile la. So I went on to pin. So pinile. Then I sew it to the armhole. Yeah, so I did the same thing for the other sleeve. Yeah, so you are done with your sleeves. Yeah, so this is the end result. Pinifale to the pelile. If you funo kshalo nga shalo boge, uti apron inzo anjano, kote VDC konak. Vele ku my channel. So yeah, this manje sinzagele apron. So I folded my fabric 2 times. So I'm cutting 2 pieces at the same time. So you can mark 14 centimeter. Oh my god, or 27. And add, you can make your 28 long makela. You can make your apron longer if you want. So mago 41 centimeter amalapa. Then I mark it, then I draw a line. You can mark 50 if you want. Once your apron to be long, so then I join there. So to draw the curve, I mark 6 centimeters there on the center of this line. Then I draw a curve. Yeah, so I draw a curve. Yeah, so styling the, yeah, so I went on to draw the curve for the bottom part. Yeah, so then I went on to cut the apron. So yeah, I was cutting 2 pieces there. There are 2 pieces for the apron. So yeah, you can make, you cut any size for the packets. Yeah, so these all are the pieces. So these are all the patterns. So I cut 2 pieces for the packet, 4 pieces for the wrapping ropes for your apron. This I cut for the ruffles, but you can cut it even longer if you want more ruffles. So I'm going to sew my packet and leave about 2 inch. I'm going to sew my rib. So here I was sewing, so really la to kneeling jalo a packet la and she is kala la pa just nana kona to turn the my packet inside out. You're going to notch around. Yeah, so I went on to sew the wrap ropes. Yeah, I sew all of them, all 4 of them. Yeah. So this is it. I sew and ironed my pieces for my packet. You see my packet, so beautiful. You can cut a even longer or squarish packet for your apron. So you will mark the center of the packet with the center of the apron and place it. This one is for the ruffles. I folded it, it's about 3 inches, so I folded it into 2. Then I make small pleats. You can cut yours even longer and make more pleats. Same thing for the other one. You can pleats amaning. Oh, the same drawing end ya kunale ela kuna ama pleats yaku azo amaning. Noma you make getters. Then I went on to sew it after pinning it. So pinil la so bobo na kisi jiganshi pinil bengaratu. So I went on to sew it. Yeah, pinil. Then I top stitched. So la. I make 2 lines of top stitching for the packet. And so no line about 2 for your packet. Massing top stitch. Yeah. You can also just add a packet without the packet without the ruffles on it. Yeah, so our apron is taking shape. So you're gonna leave about 1/2 inch at the top there, 1/2 inch at the top, and place your straps for the top there. For the ones on the bottom, you're just gonna place them at the end where the curve of the ends, you're gonna pin it. Pin it, yeah. Then you're gonna sew if you want. Yeah, so we're gonna take the other piece for the lining, then you're gonna sew all around your apron, but leave about 3 or 4 inches at the top for turning your apron. So I was notching so it will lay flat when I'm turning it inside out, being it say aganganila. So this is it. I have torn it inside out. So I'm gonna sew there where I left. So this is it. You go and customize it. You balama something lapa. Yeah, if you want to customize it, you can take it. Yeah, so yeah, this is it. Thanks for watching. Yeah, yim long koil. Yeah. Hey, le fishani nalo. Okay. Yeah, nyabonga guys for watching. Support me, nyabonga. Yeah.